Aloha and welcome back. You know, perhaps you're thinking about becoming a pet owner, but maybe you had a bad pet experience in the past. Well, don't worry. If it scares you emotionally, Dr. Edlin is here from Gentle Vets Hawaii Kai to help. And doctor, you know, you and I were talking about the break, and I've loved pets, but I remember when I was younger, unfortunately, we had a dog and he bit me. And I remember it took a while before I was comfortable with pets again. Do you see that happening and that experience as well, sir?
You know, it's good to hear that you got over it. Mm-hmm. A lot of people don't get over it. And dog bites, dogs, I love dogs. Nobody's going to deny that.
Yes,
dogs are my life. Mm-hmm. But dogs are derivative of wolves. And wolves are aggressive animals.
A wild animal.
They're wild animals. Mm-hmm. And genetically, a dog is a wolf. They can intermate.
That's amazing.
They are wolves. And as we bring them into our bedrooms, we are bringing wolves into our bedrooms. And as a result of that, currently we're seeing between 3 and 4 million human dog bites a year.
Wow.
A million of which require medical attention.
That's a lot.
It's huge.
A lot.
Mm-hmm. And that's up 50% over 20 years ago. Mm-hmm. So there's a distinct rise in dog bites. There's two reasons for that. One is the fact that we're bringing dogs into our bedroom.
Yes.
They're not out in the yard anymore.
That's right. They're sleeping in our beds now.
They're sleeping in our beds now. And the other reason is the source of the dogs. And the one of the key sources of dogs currently is rehoming of dogs. Somebody has a problem,
they
relinquish the dog, and then somebody else goes, why did they relinquish it? Because the ASPCA just came out with some good statistics. Mm-hmm. 65% of those dogs are relinquished because of either aggression, 35%, or destructive or noise problems. Separation
behaviors.
Anxiety.
Mm-hmm.
So 65% are relinquished because of behavior problems.
Wow, that much.
And then they're put in a new home.
Yeah, and the same things you have to deal with.
It's going to be the same thing.
You know, doctor, I love how you made a point, though, when we were talking. You know, these are wild animals. It's not their fault. They're dealing with new environments and new things. What should people remember? And like you said, I got over it because I had another pet and we saw that it was in. But these are animals that we need to keep in mind. What should people keep in mind, especially moving forward past the past experience?
Exactly. And one of the key things is to move forward past that bad experience and or never have that bad experience. One of the worst things that I see is when someone brings in a dog that's been relinquished because of a problem and now they have a new problem. You take a naive family that's never had a pet.
Yes.
They bring a bad dog in the house and they have a horrible problem. They, they fall in love with the dog. Even if he does bite someone of the family or someone else, they still love the dog. Mm-hmm. Now they have to give it up. They got this horrible heartbreak.
It hurts.
So don't bring that bad dog into the household in the first place. Mm-hmm. And there's the easiest way to avoid that is getting a puppy.
Yes.
In all of my years, I had one puppy that I could not turn into a good dog.
And he's worked with thousands of dogs. But talk about that, because we've talked about your puppy daycare and the system, but having a puppy and you can really work on those behavior traits early and really get comfortable with the family and do all those
things.
You can
completely convert a dog. Mm-hmm. Janelle's dog was an aggressive little nasty dog, and I got it as a puppy.
Mm-hmm.
It took me about 20 minutes. And all of a sudden, this dog is a wonderful, sweet household dog. But you got to get him sub 16 weeks old.
Mm-hmm.
A 16-week-old dog is like a 16-year-old child.
Interesting. Oh, my gosh. That's a good way to put it.
Mm-hmm. And you pretty much have to have done your work with your child before they're 16. If they get to 16 and they're a juvenile delinquent, you got a problem.
Yeah.
They're going to probably be a problem throughout their life.
You know, and I love how you talk about dogs, but you also deal with other pets, cats as well. What is the things to remember when it comes to cats and those type of things as well?
In contrast to a dog, which is the most domesticated of all animals, the cats are probably the least domesticated of all animals.
Interesting.
And so they're in our households as well, but they're in our households on their terms.
And that's how cats are. We love cats.
They are there.
But how does that change in regarding to them?
Well, one of the things about that cat is they're happy and content to lay on our windowsills and whatever else, but if they do bite you, there's one big difference between dogs and cats, and that is the cleanliness of their mouth.
Interesting.
And the bacterial load in a cat's mouth is horrible.
Oh, my gosh. It's much higher than a dog.
It's different.
Oh.
And it's much more dangerous. And when I get bit by a dog, I get a bruise or whatever else, and I clean it up, I'm not too worried about infection. When I get bit by a cat, I immediately need medical care.
Interesting.
Okay, if you get a bite from a cat, you should seek medical care. Mm-hmm. A scratch is a different thing. Clean it up.
Mm-hmm.
Clean it up well.
But a bite is, you know, a puncture
bite,
wound.
You should be seeing the you should be in the emergency room if you get a deep bite from a cat, because they have different bacteria in their mouth and those things can blow up and become life threatening in a very short order.
Wow. Well, you know, Dr. Edlin, again, if you're watching at home, I've had my young puppy be part of your puppy daycare, and it's such a great thing. He's great around pets, around people, around young and old. It makes a big, very difference. Dr. Edlin, thank you for coming in and talking about this.
Thank you, guys.
I'm amazed with all these different things, especially for cats and dogs, how the different is and stuff like that.
Now, I want people to have great experiences with their pets. And the key to that is getting a young dog, getting advice before you get the dog, before you get your heart involved in it, before you attack someone, you know, and you can nip this off at the bud. Do it beforehand.
I love it.
Not after you get the problem.
I love it. Now, again, we'll have all the information on our website, but please get part of Dr. Edlin's Gentle Vets of Waikai. That puppy daycare, it really makes a difference. Now,